Hello friends, today we are going to talk about inguinal hernias. As you must be knowing, hernias, we keep hearing about this term as to, you know, someone got operated for a hernia or this hernia got complicated. So what is exactly hernia? Now first of all, let me tell you that there are many types of hernias which occur in the body. There can be a lumbar hernia, there can be a femoral hernia, there can be an incisional hernia which happens after an operation. Today we are going to talk about the commonest form of hernia which is seen in clinical practice, and that is inguinal hernia. So as you know, the term itself says inguinal region is that region which is in the crease, where in the part of the lower abdomen and where the thigh commences, that crease of our lower abdomen, that is medically we call it as an inguinal hernia, and it extends down towards the scrotum in male and towards the pubic symphysis and the vagina in females. So that is inguinal region. So what is herniation? Hernia is a term which is used when the contents inside the abdominal cavity, we know we have the skin and the muscles on top, and below inside our bundle of our intestines, and they are actually trying to find a way out in whichever natural or abnormal opening or a potential opening they see, and the contents in the abdomen, they'll try and protrude out. Now when they protrude out in the inguinal canal, which is situated in the lower abdomen, in the crease where the thigh and the structure start, when it starts protruding there, this is called as an inguinal hernia. The good part about inguinal hernia is that most of the patients, they can actually self-diagnose it. Now how? Now usually patients who come out of a bath, they are in front of the mirror, they'll find that when they are standing, a swelling comes up in that region, either left or right side, and once they lie down or they are relaxing, the swelling disappears. This is a hallmark of hernia. So most of the patients actually self-diagnose themselves and then they come to us. The second important feature here is that the incidence of hernia in males is much more than in females. There are a lot of postulated mechanisms for that, but we are not going into the theory part of it. What I was trying to say is that an inguinal hernia can be very well diagnosed by a person who has a look at himself and finds something abnormal. The swelling can, even if the patient is lying down and if he or she coughs, there will be a bulge suddenly which will appear and then go down. So the diagnosis of hernia is mainly clinical. However, if we find that there are some other issues, some other findings with that, a good ultrasound of the lower abdomen itself is diagnostic for inguinal hernia. Should we treat hernias? Because most of them in the initial period, they are very small and they are harmless in the sense they don't have pain. But as days go by, they start producing some dragging sensation, some discomfort, which is later on replaced by pain. In some patients, the swelling which was appearing and disappearing starts to be there. It doesn't go down completely. Now, this is the first sign of what we medically call as irreducible hernia. Now, this is the first sign for the patient to understand that this hernia can have a potential problem, can have pain and something like that. So, I was coming slowly to the complication part actually. So, what happens is, once the hernia gets irreducible or it doesn't go back, it can produce pain, it can produce severe pain in an emergency, so much so that if a portion of intestine is stuck in the hernia, it can cause the blood supply to compromise and lead to very horrendous complications. What we commonly refer to as an intestinal gangrene. If a loop of intestine is stuck inside, the last condition or the last step is a gangrene. But in all this process, the patient is going to get a lot of pain. So, why we should treat hernia? To avoid a bad or terrible complication. The hernias can be operated. The patients who who are treated with hernia usually undergo a surgery. There is no medical treatment for hernia. Please understand this. A lot of people believe that if hernia is small, you can leave it like that and see if it becomes bigger or if it grows bigger and produces problem. Sorry to say, but that's not the best approach towards hernia. So better to treat them when they are smaller in size and they are not having problems. Surgery is a straightforward thing. Usually a patient needs a hospitalization for a day or two. These operations can be done very successfully by an open operation as well as by a laparoscopic operation. We at our center calls, we have been handling patients of both the varieties. We have patients who have undergone open surgery and laparoscopic procedures as well. The results of both operations are very good and with minimum side effects or complications. And so, my sincere request to all the patients who are seeing us and who are listening to us is that try and see if someone is in distress because of hernia, because it's a condition which can be very successfully treated. It is an operation which gives you a lot of dividends when you don't have complication. And therefore, rather than suffering with anxiety, later on pain and complications, come forward, diagnose, get yourself diagnosed, and a simple operation is going to make you smile and is going to make your life much more simple. For any such patients who need help for an hernia issue, you are most welcome to contact our number 7799732222. You can also log on to our website, which is www.drchetanmahajan.com, and we are always there to help you. Last word of caution, it's always better, like so many other conditions, to treat hernias without complications when they are reducible and they have not got into other systemic problems. Because patients who have comorbidities like diabetes, hypertension and all, they will face more problems to undergo surgery in an emergency. Therefore, choose an opportune time to get yourself treated and life becomes simple. Thank you very much.